Hello students, in the first two lectures we studied about charges, current, potential difference, Ohm's law and dependence of resistance on length and cross section area. If we summarize, we get the four formulas, in which the third and fourth formula is very important. The first formula is I is equal to Q upon T. We know I is current, Q is charge and T is time. We measure charge in coulomb, time in second and I in ampere. So from formula it is very clear that current is rate of flow of charge. The second formula is V is equal to W by Q, where W is work done, V is potential difference or voltage and Q is charge. We know that the definition, that is work done to move a charge from one point to another. The third is Ohm's law, that says that under constant physical condition like temperature, pressure, the voltage is directly proportional to the current. So V is equal to IR, and the last formula is R is equal to rho L upon A, which says that resistance is directly proportional to length and resistance of conductor is inversely proportional to the cross section area. Here rho is a specific resistance or resistivity, or we can say that the resistance of a unit cube of a material which is constant for a certain material, because rho is a constant that is introduced, and a length is length of conductor in meter and area is cross section area in meter square. So let us go with the numericals. Whenever we solve numerical, I told you in class 9th as well that always try to write what is given in the question, and to write whatever is given in the question, you have to first read. If you will be able to read the questions, then you will be able to solve the questions and write what is given. Once you have given, write what you have to find, and once you know what to find and what is given, by applying formulas or write down all the formulas that you know, and any of the formula will be applicable and you will get the answer. So let us move to the first question. The first question is, an electric iron draws a current of 3.4 ampere from a 220 volt supply line. What current will same electric iron draws when connected to a 110 volt supply? So in first case it is given that the current that is being drawn from circuit is from the supply is 3.4 ampere and the supply line is 220 volt. So always remember that in India this standard voltage supply is 220 volt. So because we know that R is constant, that is introduced in V is equal to IR formula. So here you can see that the voltage is being halved, so we can say that the current will also be halved, but by solving we will find the same. So let us see the first condition. V is equal to 220 volt, I is equal to 3.4 ampere. From here we can find what is the value of resistance. Formula is V is equal to IR, so R is equal to V upon I, and V is 220 volt, I is 3.4 ohm, so 3.4 ampere, so resistance becomes 64.7 ohm. Now for the second condition, that is 110 volt supply, now resistance is same, that is 64.7 ohm, and the new voltage is V dash is 110 volt. So let us rewrite the formula, that is V dash is equal to I dash R. So I dash is the new current that is flowing through the iron. Now I dash is equal to V dash upon R, and I dash is 1.7 ampere. So you can see that 220 volt jo hai wo V dash ka double hai, or 1.7 ka double 3.4 hai. So you can easily say that when the voltage is doubled, if the resistance is unchanged, then the current is doubled, and if the resistance is unchanged, if the voltage is half, current is halved. So let us go to the next question. The next question is, when a 12 volt battery is connected across an unknown resistor, there is a current of 2.5 milliampere. Now here the current is in milliampere, so we have to change that into ampere, because we know that in physics we always take the standard units. Now we have to find the resistance. So given is V is equal to 12 volt and I is equal to 2.5 milliampere. So to change milliampere into ampere, we'll multiply by 10 to the power minus 3, as like we change millimeter into meter, and we know that meter is standard form of length. If the current was in microampere, we would have multiplied by 10 to the power minus 6. Now by the formula V is equal to IR, we can say that R is equal to V upon I, and V is 12 and I is 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 3, and we get the value of resistance to be 4800 ohm. So you can see how easy is the question. Once you write what is given, you can easily find what is asked to find in the question. So let us see the next question. The next question is, a 6 ohm resistance wire is doubled by folding. Calculate the new resistance. Now that means you have a wire whose length is fixed and whose cross section area is fixed. Now you are just doubling the same wire by folding. So that means to double, you would be folding from the half. Thus the resistance and the length and the area both are changing, and you are not adding any additional wire. So the parameters that are being affected is length as well as cross section area, not only the cross section area. So we can write R is equal to 6 ohm, let the original length be L, cross section area be A, and resistivity be rho. We know that the resistivity of material will not change because same material is being folded. So R is equal to rho L upon A, or we can put the value of R that is equal to 6, then 6 is equal to rho L upon A, which is our first equation. Now when the wire is being doubled by folding, length becomes L by 2 and area becomes 2 times. So we can find the new resistance, that is R dash. R dash becomes rho L upon A, in place of L will write L by 2, and in place of A will write 2A. So R dash becomes rho L upon 4A. Now we have to find how it is changing. So either we can divide R upon R dash, or we can just take 1 by 4 common in R dash, then we can write 1 by 4 in bracket rho L upon A, and rho L upon A we know that the value is 6, so we can easily find the new resistance, that is R dash is equal to 1 by 4 into 6, that is 1 by 4 times, and it is 1.5 ohm. Always remember, because such questions are very important for exams as well as in competition point of view, that the length or the cross section area can be changed by two ways, either by adding extra material, or if you have same volume of material you can double it, or you can reduce the cross section area by stretching or by folding the wire. Now why we took L upon 2 and area 2A? Because the volume of material was not changing. We had same volume of material. What we did was we doubled the cross section area, and in the process the area becomes 2A, and in the same process the length becomes L upon 2. But if we wanted to just increase the area, we could have also added or one more piece of wire onto the existing wire just to increase the area and not affecting the length. Let us see the next question. So the next question is, a copper wire has a diameter of 0.5 millimeter and resistivity of 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. Now the question that was asked is, what will be the length of wire to make its resistance 10 ohm, and how much resistance change is there if diameter is doubled? Let us solve the first part. So in first part, diameter is given, that is 0.5 millimeter. We can easily find radius, that is d upon 2, that is becomes 0.25 millimeter. I told you the first thing is that we change millimeter into meter, that is in standard form. So we'll multiply by 10 to the power minus 3, and r becomes 10 to the power minus 3 0.25 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. So if we find area is pi r square, that is 22 upon 7, and in place of r 0.25 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square, by solving we'll get 0.1964 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter square. Now specific resistivity or resistance or resistivity is given, rho is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter, and the resistance that is given is 10 ohm. Let the length be L. Now by the formula R is equal to rho L upon A, we know that we have to find the value of L. L is nothing but RA upon rho. If we put the value of RA and rho, we can easily get the value of length. So L becomes 10 into 10 to the power 0.1964 into 10 to the power minus 6 upon 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 8. If we solve, we'll get, the easiest way is that take all the power of 10 together, and once you get, you will get 10 to the power minus, 10 to the power plus 3. And if you multiply 10 to the power plus 3, the decimal will move 3 places right hand side, and you will get 196.4 upon 1.6. Or by removing decimal, you can write length is 1964 upon 16, that is 122.7 meter. And the second part was asked is, what is the change if the diameter is doubled? Now see, only the diameter is being doubled. It is not written that the wire is being folded. So if the wire is not being folded, that means it is being doubled by any other method. But and then by doubling, that means the volume of the material is also changing. The length is not changed, only the diameter is being changed. So let us see what is the impact of diameter on resistance. Earlier we studied that resistance is directly proportional to length. That is, if length is doubled, R is doubled. If length is halved, R is halved. So here in the question, length was not changing, so we will not see the length. We also know that R is inversely proportional to 1 upon A, inversely proportional to A. Or we can say that if A is doubled, R is halved, and if A is halved, R is doubled. But we are not also seeing the area. We want to know what is the impact of diameter. Let us solve and find. So we know R is equal to rho L upon A, and here the length, let L be constant, and area is pi R square. We don't want R, we take diameter. So R is equal to D upon 2. If we square, we'll get pi D square upon 4. If we put the value of A in R, we'll get rho L upon pi D square upon 4, or that is equal to, if we solve, R is equal to rho 4 rho L upon pi D square. That is equation number 1. Now let the diameter be doubled. If the diameter is being doubled, the new area A dash becomes pi, in place of D we write 2D, that is 2D whole square upon 4. We get new area to be pi D square. Now let us put that area in the formula of resistance. The new resistance R dash is equal to rho L upon A dash, because L is not changing. We are taking same L, also we are taking same rho because the material also not changing. So in place of A dash, we write pi D square, that is equation number 2. So let us divide equation 1 by equation 2. Why? Because we want to know what is the change in resistance. So if we divide, we'll get R upon R dash is equal to 4 rho L upon pi D square, and upon rho L upon pi D square. Rho L upon pi D square, rho L upon pi D square is common, which will cancel out, and we'll get R upon R dash is equal to 4. So R dash is equal to R upon 4. Thus we can see, if the resistance is being, if the diameter is being doubled, the resistance become 1 by 4 times. Thus we can conclude as, the resistance of wire is inversely proportional to the square of diameter. If the diameter is being doubled, R becomes 1 by 4 times, and if diameter is being halved, R becomes 4 times. So coming back to the same question, how much resistance change is there if diameter is being doubled? So we can simply write, if the diameter is being doubled, the resistance becomes 1 by 4 times. Like this, if the diameter is being doubled, then resistance becomes 1 by 4 times. So remember, whenever you solve the questions, whatever question you see, try to write whatever is given in the question, and then try to find what is asked and put in the formula, and you will get the answer. The calculations may be hard, but don't assume it to be hard. Once you start practicing more and more numericals, you'll be able to solve it. And also it is said, practice again and again and you will become perfect one day. So don't get afraid of numerical. It is very easy. It is just your will that will make you solve. Till then, thank you and stay safe at home. If there is any doubt, you can come up with your doubts in the class, and I'll try to just clear all your doubts.